Example one, that is show that the point in the argand diagram represented by the complex numbers 1 + 3i, 4 - 3i, 5 - 5i are collinear. Show that the points in the argand diagram represented by the complex numbers 1 + 3i, 4 - 3i, 5 - 5i are collinear. First, I will take this one. That p is nothing but 1 + 3i. This we have written as 1 + i × 3 will write. We have to write in order where 1, 3 will write. After we will take q is nothing but 4 - 3i will write. This we have to write. 4 + i × - 3 will write. This we have to write. 4, -3. After we'll take the another point, q is nothing but 5 - 5i is given. This we have to write. 5 + 5 × - 5 will write. We have to write their order pair of a complex number, that we have to write 5, -5. Okay, collinear means we will take slope of PQ is nothing but slope of QR. Both are equal, then P, Q, and R will be collinear. First, I will take slope of AB bar is nothing but, what is the required formula mean? Y2 - Y1 / X2 - X1 will take, where A is nothing but 1, 3. After that, B is nothing but 4, -3. This will write X1, Y1. This is nothing but X2, Y2 will write. I have to substitute in this value. -3 - 3/4 - 1. That is the value. -3 is nothing but -2. This is the value slope of AB bar. After we'll take slope of nothing but AB. This is nothing but PQ. This is P. After we'll take, this is Q. After we'll take slope of QR is nothing but, here also we'll take Y2 - Y1 / X2 - X1 will write, where Q is nothing but 4, -3. R is nothing but 5, -5. This will take X1, Y1. After we'll take X2, Y2 will take. How to substitute in this one? -5 - -3 becomes +3 by. After we'll take where X2 we will become 5, X1 will become 4. That way how to write -5 + 3 - -2/1 is nothing but -2. We will observe in this two statements. Slope of PQ bar is nothing but -2, as well as slope of QR bar is also -2. That I will write. Slope of PQ bar is equal to slope of QR bar. Slope of PQ is equal to slope of PR means, this we have to write, that is P, Q, and R are collinear. Collinear. This is asking given problem. Now I am going to example 2. Find the equation of the straight line. Find the equation of the straight line joining the point represented by -4 + 3i, comma 2 - 3i in the argand plane. You'll observe in this one. Find the equation of the straight line joining the points represented by -4 + 3i, comma 2 - 3i in the argand plane that I will write. Given points, let us say, let A is nothing but -4 + 3i, that must be written as i into 3. We have to write in this complex number into order pair, that we have to return as -4, 3. After we'll take B is nothing but 2 - 3i. This will return as 2 + i into -3 will write. Order pair of 2, -3 will write. Okay, but in this problem, find the equation of a straight line. We will find in this problem, that means we have to find out the straight line AB bar is, we'll observe, let x1, x2 and y1, y2 be are any two points, then the straight line AB is, what we have to write in this one means y - y1 is nothing but y2 - y1 by x2 - x1 into x - x1 will write. Okay, here we'll take A and B, where A is nothing but -4, 3. After we'll take B is nothing but 2, -3. This is x1, y1. After we'll take, this is x2, y2. I have to substitute in this one. y1 is nothing but 3. y2 is -3. -y1 is 3. Where x2 is 2. x1 is -4. -4 will become +4. After that, x - x1 will become 4, -4 will become +4. That we have to write. y - 3 is equal to -6/6 into x + 4 will write. 6 and 6 will be cancelled. Remaining, that we have to write. y - 3 is nothing but -x - 4. These values becomes this side. x + y, -4 becomes this side, that I will write. 4 - 3 is equal to 0. Finally, that we have to write. x + y + 1 is equal to 0. This is the equation of the straight line PQ. Same ide problem nana. Similar problem in exercise 1D, 1D, first section law, second problem. That is homework. Okay, no. After now, I am going to next one. That is example 3. First I write example 3. Z is equal to x plus iy. Represent a point in the argand plane. The point in the argand plane. Find the locus of Z such that mod Z is equal to 2. After now I will write example 4 also. The point P represents a complex number Z. A complex number Z in the argand plane. If the amplitude of Z is pi by 4. Determine the locus of P. What is given first one? Z is equal to x plus iy represents a point in the argand plane. Find the locus of Z such that mod Z is equal to 2 is given. First I will write Z is nothing but x plus iy. We have to find the locus of Z. And also one more condition is given, that is such that mod Z is nothing but 2. Mod Z means we will write x plus iy is nothing but 2. We'll observe mod Z means that I will write x square plus y square is nothing but 2. Okay, squaring on both sides, here we have to write in this one x square plus y square is nothing but 2 square. Okay, this we have to compare with x square plus y square is nothing but r square. This is required circle equation with the center 0, 0. We will write there center C is nothing but 0, 0. After we will write the radius r is nothing but r square is 2 square, then r is nothing but 2, we'll write. This is the given required locus of Z. Here, I am going to next one, that is the point P represents a complex number Z in the argand plane. If the amplitude of Z is pi by 4 given, determine the locus of P. We will find out this one. Once again, we will observe in this one. The point P represents a complex number Z in the argand plane. If the amplitude of Z is also pi by 4 is given, first I will write, let the complex number that Z is nothing but x plus iy will take. After one more statement is given, that is the amplitude of Z is pi by 4 is given. That I will write, amplitude of Z is nothing but pi by 4. That I have to write. Tan inverse y by x is nothing but pi by 4. We'll write. Again, we'll take y by x is nothing but tan pi by 4. Pi by x is nothing but tan pi by 4, we'll write. Tan pi by 4 is nothing but sin pi by 4 by cos pi by 4, we'll write. Sin pi by 4 is nothing but 1 by root 2, as well as cos pi by 4 is nothing but 1 by root 2, we'll write. That is, x is equal to y is equal to 1 by root 2, we'll write. X is equal to y is equal to 1 by root 2 means both x and y are equal. That I will write. The locus of z, given locus of z, that I will write here. X is also, we'll observe in this one, here x is also greater than or equal to 0, y is also greater than or equal to 0. X is also locus of z here. X is also greater than or equal to 0, and y is also greater than or equal to 0. Then, given locus of z, that I will write where x comma y, where the given order pair x comma y belongs to, where square number, that I will write real number whole square, such that where x is also greater than 0 and y is also greater than 0, that I will write x greater than 0 comma y greater than 0, and will satisfy one more condition, that is x is equal to y is equal to 1 by 2, we'll take, that is x is equal to y. This is the given locus of z. After now, I am going to example 5. If the point P denotes the complex number z is equal to x plus iy in the argand plane and if z minus i by z minus 1 is a purely imaginary number, find the locus of P. This is the given problem. What is given in this one? If the point P denotes the complex number z is equal to x plus iy, is given. And also one more statement is given, z minus I by z minus 1 is a purely imaginary number, that I will write. Z minus I by z minus 1 is a purely imaginary number. This is a purely imaginary number means where real part will be 0, that I will write. Real part of z minus I by z minus 1 is nothing but 0. When it is purely real number means their imaginary part will be 0. When it is purely imaginary number means their real part will be 0. First, I have to find out the value of z minus I. That means z minus I by z minus 1 is nothing but where z is x plus I by minus I by x plus iy minus 1, will write. I have to separate the real and imaginary part. X plus iy minus I by their denominator, that I have to write. X minus 1 plus iy, will write. The conjugate of x minus 1 plus iy is nothing but x minus 1 minus I y will write their denominator also x minus 1. Here also I will common with I, that will be written as I into y minus 1 will write. Here also minus x minus 1 minus I y will write. You will observe in this one, how to multiply in this one? X plus I into y minus 1 into x minus 1 minus I y by, where the given denominator, it is of the form a plus b into a minus c, that I will write x minus 1 whole square minus I square y square will write. How to expand in this one? X into x minus 1, after that minus I into x y, after that plus I into x minus 1 into y minus 1, plus into minus will become minus I square is minus 1, minus into minus is plus, remaining we have to write y into y minus 1 by, their denominator is x minus 1 whole square plus y square will write. We have to separate their real and the imaginary part. Have to separate the real and the imaginary part we will get. That I will write where the real part is x into x minus 1, after that plus y into y minus 1, where given imaginary part is I will common with I, remaining that I have to written as x minus 1 into y minus 1 minus xy by, their denominator that I have to write x minus 1 whole square plus y square will write. Here we have to separate it, the real and imaginary part, x into x is nothing but x square, y into y is y square, minus x minus y by, their denominator is nothing but x minus 1 whole square plus y square. After I will common with I, remaining that we have to written as x minus 1 into y minus 1 minus xy by, their denominator is x minus 1 whole square plus y square will write. This is the real part of, this is the real part of z minus I by z minus 1. This is the imaginary part of z minus I by z minus 1. Now I am going to from 1. What it says from 1? From 1 says real part of z minus I by z minus 1 is nothing but 0. This is the given real part. That I will write x square plus y square minus x minus y by, x minus 1 whole square plus y square is nothing but 0. 0 into any value will become 0. That I will write x square plus y square minus x minus y is nothing but 0. This is required locus of z. This is also circle equation, excluding the point 1 comma 0 also will write. This is intavargaina raichu lekunte, this is a given circle equation excluding the point 1 comma 0 also will write. This is asking this one. Okay, Nana, after now I am going to example 6. What is asking in example 6? Describe describe geometrically the following subset of C. And the first one is Z belongs to C, that means, and also mod of Z minus 1 plus I is nothing but 1. It is the second one also given, that is Z belongs to C such that mod of Z plus I is less than or equal to 3. Here we will observe. Describe geometrically the following subset. First, now I am going to first one, that is what is given in this one. Given set, let us take that S is nothing but Z belongs to C such that mod of Z minus 1 plus I is nothing but 1 will write. Z belongs to C means that I will write the pair of Z, the outer pair of Z, that must I have to write. X comma y belongs to their real part whole square such. Here we'll take z is nothing but x plus I y will write. That means x plus I y minus 1 plus I is nothing but 1 will write. That means S is nothing but x comma y belongs to R square such that. Here we have to write in this one x minus 1 plus I into y plus 1 will write. This is nothing but 1. This is mod of x plus I y, that we have to write x comma y belongs to R square such that. Here we have to write root of x minus 1 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square is nothing but 1. Here by using this given condition, squaring on both sides, we will get this one. S is equal to x comma y belongs to R square such that x minus 1 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square is nothing but 1 square will write. This is the circle equation. This is the circle equation means we have to write the center and the radius, where center C is nothing but h comma k. And given one, when it is of the form x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is nothing but r square will write, where center is nothing but 1 comma minus 1. After that, radius small r is nothing but 1. Given circle equation is of the form x minus h whole square. Here we will write in this place. Given circle equation, when it is of the form x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is nothing but r square will write. After now I am going to second one. Here the second one is, here also we will take that S is nothing but Z belongs to C such that mod of Z plus I is less than or equal to 3. Here we'll take S is nothing but we have to write Z in order pair, that I will write x comma y belongs to R square such that mod of x plus I y plus I is less than or equal to 3 will write. That means S is nothing but x comma y belongs to R square such that mod of x plus I into y plus 1 is less than or equal to 3 will write. Given one can be written as x comma y belongs to R square such that mod of a plus ib, that I have written as root of x square plus y plus 1 whole square is nothing but 3 will write. here by using this condition, squaring on both sides, we will get this one. S is nothing but x comma y belongs to R square, such that x minus 0 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square is nothing but 3 square will write. Here we will observe in this one, given one is a closed circular disk. Given one is a closed circular disk. Why? Because of here given symbol is less than or equal to. When it is equal, given one is a circle. When it is by using the symbol less than or equal to means given one is a circular disk. This we have to compare with x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is less than or equal to r square. This is closed circular disk. This is closed circular disk. When it is a closed circular disk means here also we have to write their center and radius, where center C is nothing but 0 comma minus 1 will write. After that, radius small r is nothing but 3. This is the given center and radius of expression. After now, I am going to next one. Okay, Nana. Now I am going to exercise 1D. Now I am going to exercise 1D. I will take the first problem. Find the equation of the perpendicular bisector of the line segment joining the point 7 plus 7i comma 7 minus 7i in the argand plane. This is most important for two marks problem. We'll observe in this one. Find the equation of the perpendicular bisector of the line segment. Joining the points 7 plus 7i comma 7 minus 7i in the argand plane. Let us take first complex number. 7 plus I into 7 will write, that is the given point is 7 comma 7 will write. After that second point B will take 7 plus of I into minus 7 will write, this is the point 7 comma minus 7 will write. Find the equation of perpendicular bisector of line segment. I will draw a graph. X axis is perpendicular bisector of Y axis. I will take two points. This is nothing but A, this is nothing but B. The perpendicular bisector of two points, name it as P and Q. This is the midpoint O will take. Here A is nothing but 7 comma 7. After that B is nothing but 7 comma minus 7 will write. We know that the values A and B, we have to find out O. O. O is equal to the midpoint of AB bar. O is nothing but the midpoint of AB bar, means that I will write x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. X1 is nothing but 7. X2 is nothing but x1 y1, this is x2 y2, 7 plus 7 by 2 comma, where y1 is nothing but 7, y2 is minus 7 by 2, that I will write. 7 plus 7 is 14, 14 by 2 is nothing but 7, 0 by any value is 0. This is the point O. This is the point O. After we have to find out the slope of AB, here we have to find out slope of AB bar is nothing but, slope of AB bar is nothing but, what is the formula? Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1 will write. Here we have to write A and B. A is 7 comma 7. This is nothing but X1 comma Y1. After we'll take B. B is nothing but 7 comma minus 7. This is nothing but x2 comma y2 will write. But where y2 is minus 7, y1 is minus 7, x2 is 7, x1 is also 7. That is, what about the value? Minus 14 by 0. Minus 14 by 7 minus 7. Slope of AB bar is nothing but y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 will write, minus 14 by 0. 0 by any value is 0, but any value by 0 is nothing but infinity. Slope of AB bar is infinity, means that I will take infinity, means that I will write 1 by 0 also will write. Okay, but slope of AB bar is perpendicular to PQ bar. Perpendicular to BQ bar means this will write 1 by 0 will write. 1 by minus 14 by 0. We will write the reciprocal of given one. This is minus 14 by 0. We will write in this one 1 by. We will write in this one 1 by minus 0 by 14 also will write. Okay. 1 by minus 0 by 14 is nothing but slope of PQ bar. Slope of PQ bar is nothing but 1 by 0 by 14, that I will write. This is infinity will take. Infinity is nothing but 1 by 0 also will write. Where that means slope of AB bar is nothing but infinity. And also I will take, will explain one more also. Slope of AB bar is infinity, then slope of PQ bar. Slope of PQ bar is nothing but, we'll observe, slope of PQ. PQ is perpendicular to AB, means that I will write 1 by slope of AB bar, that will be right. That means 1 by minus 14 by 0. This value becomes this side. 0 by minus 14 is nothing but 0. That means slope of PQ bar is nothing but 0. Slope of P PQ bar is nothing but zero. We will observe in this one. We know that the point O, O is nothing but 7 comma 0 and the slope PQ bar is 0. After we have to find out in this one, equation of PQ. I will take the equation of PQ bar is, what is the given formula here? Y minus Y1 is equal to M into X minus X1 will write. Here we'll take the point O is nothing but 7 comma 0. That I will take, this is the given point. O is nothing but 7 comma 0. That will take X1 comma Y1. After we'll take M. Slope of PQ bar. Slope M is nothing but 0. I will write this one. Slope of PQ bar is nothing but 0. This will take the value of M. We have to substitute in this one that I will write. Y minus 0 is nothing but 0 into X minus 7 will write. 0 into any value is 0. That I will write. Y is equal to 0. Y is equal to 0 means it represents X axis. This is the given locus of Z will write. Given locus of Z will write.
Here to buy good in cloud here at the time.
ఓకే నాన్న ఇన్ ఫస్ట్ సెక్షన్ సెకండ్ ప్రాబ్లం ఆల్రెడీ ఇందాకనే చెప్పాను ఆ మోడల్ అది హోంవర్క్ సెకండ్ వన్ ఆల్రెడీ నిన్న క్లాస్ లో చెప్పాను నౌ ఐ యామ్ గోయింగ్ టు థర్డ్ వన్ Now I am going to third point, that is third problem. Show that the points in the argand diagram represented by the complex number represented by a complex number 2 plus 2y comma minus 2 minus 2y comma minus 2 root 3 plus 2 root 3i are the vertices of an equilateral triangle. We'll observe in this one. Show that the points in the argand diagram represented by the complex number 2 plus 2i comma minus 2 minus 2i comma minus 2 root 3 plus 2 root 3 into i are the vertices of a equilateral triangle. When given points are satisfies equilateral triangle means in a triangle all sides are must be equal. AB is equal to BC, BC is equal to CA. AB is equal to BC is equal to CA, then given points are lies in a equilateral triangle. First I will take let A is nothing but 2 plus I into 2 will write. The order pair of given one will write 2 comma 2. After we'll take the second one, B is nothing but minus 2 plus I into minus 2 will write. This is also minus 2 comma minus 2 will write. After that, C is nothing but minus 2 root 3 plus I into 2 root 3 will write. Order pair of given one also can be written as minus 2 root 3 comma 2 root 3 will write. You know that the points A, B, C. First we have to check it A, B. After we will check B, C. After we will check it A, C. A, B is equal to B, C is equal to C, A. Then the given triangle is equilateral triangle. After that, this is not A, equilateral triangle. First I will take A, B. Distance between A, B is nothing but x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square pair. A is nothing but 2 comma 2. B is minus 2 comma 2. We'll write this is x1 comma y1. This is x2 comma y2. We'll write that is square root of where x2 is nothing but minus 2. X1 is nothing but 2 whole square plus y2 is minus 2. Y1 is 2 whole square, that is minus 4 whole square is nothing but 16. Here also 16. 16 plus 16 is root 32. Root 32 that we have to written as 16 into 2. 16 is a root of 4 that I will write 4 root 2. This is nothing but AB. After we have to find out BC. The distance between BC also using the formula x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. We have to take where b is nothing but minus 2 comma minus 2. C is nothing but minus 2 root 3 comma. This will take x1 comma y1. C will take minus 2 root 3 comma 2 root 3. This is x2 comma y2 will write. That is square root of where x2 is nothing but minus 2 root 3. X1 is nothing but minus 2. Minus of minus 2 is plus 2 will write. After that, where y2 is nothing but 2 root 3. Minus of minus 2 will become plus 2 whole square. We have to expand in this one. We have to expand in this one that I will write. Minus 2 root 3 whole square. Here we have to write 2 minus 2 root 3 whole square. Again, this also I have to write 2 plus 2 root 3 whole square. Given one minute is of the form A minus B whole square plus A plus B whole square. That we have to written as 2 into A square plus B square will write. Here also root of 2 into where A is nothing but 2 square. B is nothing but 2 root 3 whole square will write. That is root of 2 into 4 plus. We'll observe 4, 3 is 12. 12 plus 4 is 16. 16 twos is nothing but 32. 32 is nothing but 4 root 2. This is the value of BC. After we have to find out CA. After we have to find out the distance between CA is nothing but root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square will take. Where C is nothing but minus 2 root 3 comma 2 root 3. And also where A is nothing but 2 comma 2. This will take x1 comma y1. After we'll take this one, x2 comma y2 will write. That is CA is nothing but root of where x2 is nothing but 2. 2 plus of minus into minus will become plus. 2 root 3 whole square. Again, this we have to written as 2 minus 2 root 3 whole square. Again, when it is of the form A plus B whole square plus A minus B whole square is nothing but 2 into A square plus B square will write. Here also, CA is nothing but 2 into 2 square plus 2 root 3 whole square. This is nothing but CA is equal to 2 into 16, that is nothing but 32. 32 is nothing but 4 root 2. This is the value of CA. We will observe in this three conditions that I will write. AB is equal to BC is equal to CA is equal to whatever the given length here. 4 root 2 is the given length. That means the side AB is equal to BC is equal to CA. All are equal. That means given vertices can form a equilateral triangle. That is triangle ABC is a equilateral triangle. Triangle ABC is a equilateral triangle. We'll write. Okay, Nana. We'll write this one. Tomorrow we'll complete this chapter. So I'm sorry, day after tomorrow.